I'm here in Rock Hill talking to Connor Fields, an Olympian and a gold medalist in the Rio de Janeiro Olympics. We're just going to talk to him about this upcoming BMX tournament and his take on the stadium. So this is your first time being back in a year. What are your expectations for yourself?
Yeah, like you said, I've been here a few times before, and Rock Hill always hosts a great event. But, you know, this is the short after the Olympics, this is the biggest event we have in the sport. So, you know, this is going to be huge. There's going to be people from all over the world here. And as you can see, they've really done it up, you know, with all the different venues and everything. And I think it'll be really cool once it's all set up and once we get racing.
Okay, now you've been to the Olympics twice. What was your first Olympics experience?
First one was tough. You know, I was only 19 years old, and I didn't really know what to expect. And, you know, I made the finals, but, you know, I just really, to be honest, I wasn't ready for the moment. And I think the, you know, the pressure of the moment or whatever you want to say, it got the best of me. And I didn't bring a medal home. But I think what it did is it taught me, and I learned a lot from it. And I was more prepared when I went to Rio this time around, and I knew what to expect. And definitely was a better experience.
Okay, now when did it change for you? When did things change and your mentality change to make you a gold medalist?
Yeah, I think for me, it was just, you know, learning how to lose, if that makes sense. So, you know, when you lose, you have to be able to identify what you did wrong and how you can get better and how you can fix it. And, you know, it's hard as an athlete. You know, you dedicate your whole life to something to stop and be like, okay, I lost. Well, why'd I lose? You know, it's hard to think about that. So for me, you know, as I got older and I got some more life experience and I matured, I was able to, you know, learn from those mistakes and try to correct them.
I don't know if you've actually explored Rock Hill any. Have you had a chance to explore?
Yeah, I've been here plenty of times, so I've been all over. I've been to Charlotte, been to Rock Hill, Fort Mill, all the surrounding areas, yeah.
Are there any places in the city that you're looking forward to visiting while you're here?
You know, I wish it was already football season. A couple of years ago, we went to a Panthers game, which was really cool. The World Cup was in September, so it was football season, and we raced on Saturday, and then we went to the football game on Sunday, so that was really cool. And I'd love to be able to go to another one, but unfortunately, it's a bit early this year.
Now, you are the man to beat in this tournament, if that's safe to say. Is that safe to say?
In the sport of BMX, you really can't point a finger at any one guy and say he's the man to beat. I mean, the competition is so high. I mean, there's 10, 15 people from around the world that if they won, it wouldn't be a huge surprise. So, you know, at the end of the day, just going to go out and do my best and, you know, see what happens.
Okay, now, if you weren't a BMX athlete, what do you think you would be doing in life right now?
I don't know. It's tough. I think I would have played another sport, definitely. I was always an athletic guy, and I really love sports. And I always had this drive and this will to want to be the best. So I think regardless of which sport I played, I probably would have went as far as I could with it. So maybe I'd be a football player in college, or who knows, maybe I would have taken up golf or something and been good at that. I don't know.
Now, you've been out here practicing pretty hard for quite a while.
Yeah.
What is the one thing that you're working on that you hope to execute in this next tournament?
You know, with BMX, there's so much that goes into it. You know, it's not necessarily one thing, but, you know, I've got my plan for what I want to do on race day and you know, the lines I want to take and the way I want to hit certain sections. And today was our last day of riding before the event. They're going to shut the track down tomorrow. So today was really just about focusing on all the things that I want to do out there and, you know, ride the track the way I want to ride it and just kind of mentally getting ready for the race day.
Okay, now BMX is slowly but surely becoming more mainstream. Who do you want to see in the stands?
Ooh, you know, for me, I'm really excited because my grandparents are from Atlanta, so just down the road, and they haven't seen me race in person at a world level event ever. So I'm really looking forward for my grandparents to be here. My aunt and uncle are coming out. My mom and dad are going to be here. So my girlfriend's going to be here as well. So I'm going to have my whole family here. So for me, it doesn't get any better than that.
Okay, well, there you have it. We've spoken to an Olympian, a gold medalist, Connor Fields. Thank you for your time, and we'll be back right after this.
Carolina Connection is brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. For more information, visit foundersfcu.com. Relax, you're with Founders.